People who used to cheat in every possible exam and assignment, where are you now? Nice try, Professor. I'm not falling for it. I programmed my scientific calculator to include all the physics formulas I needed. You could just input variables and it would spit out solutions. I ended up in the music industry. I did the same for mechanical engineering. Professor asked why I didn't have the work, and showed him my calculator. He was actually impressed and allowed it. Said I had to share with my classmates. Thing was, I was poor, so I had the Casio graphing calc instead of the Texas Instruments T84 or whatever. The program wouldn't transfer, so guess who got the program? Me and the other poor students with the Casios. There was four of us. Wildland firefighter, don't really have to put any papers in my bag anymore. Though I do subscribe to the stuff your tent in the bag strategy over folding it. You can just burn all evidence now. Smart. The thing about cheating versus real life is that you can look up everything in real life. I have a good background education and years of experience in my field, yet I constantly look up things, double check my work, and ask others' opinions on how they might approach a task. I saw a TikTok that was, name your unpopular teaching method that actually works, and this teacher let students take all their tests and exam with their notes. What she found was students took better notes, paid attention more, and there was less of a feeling of unfairness for kids that were schooled at home versus in person. Her reasoning was just that, it's pretty rare that you won't be able to not look up an answer to something when you need to. Construction engineer, joke of a curriculum and really just needs a lot of field experience. Also construction, my first day on the job they said I don't know what you learned in college or tech school. I'ma tell you now, it's probably wrong. I have never cheated on an exam and never would, but I use Chegg constantly for homework assignments. Why? Who the fuck wants to spend 8 hours in a library on a sunny, Saturday afternoon trying to figure out 6 to 7 problems that in the end are about 2% of your grade? I don't feel bad because some of these homework assignments are so freaking tedious and many professors don't even give a shit about teaching the material right and making it interesting to students. A lot of these homework assignments for classes like statics and thermodynamics are a complete fucking waste of time. I think you speak for every college student in the world. The kids in my HS who did the best were simply the best cheaters at it. For some context, I went to a huge HS. Sitting in front of the lockers copying assignments was a common sight. So true. All the AP honors kids in my school cheat more than the lowest level class kids do. Teacher. What do you do if you catch a student cheating? Pediatric nurse. I thought my nursing program was easy academically. Science has always come easy to me, so I had no trouble with any of the actual core nursing curriculum. What I hated was papers and something called nursing care plans. These take a long time to write up, so I just started making them up, copying old ones from friends who had graduated before me and cut out a lot of BS work writing those. Haven't done a single nursing care plan as an actual nurse in 15 years. I fully support this. I proofread, meaning rewrote, two friends' care plans so they could pass psych class. They were good students, they just sucked at writing, and I found it awful that a single paper could make up 50% of our final grades. I mean, I assume everyone cheated a little, but per your prompt, last I've seen from that kid from high school, he spent lockdown using his yacht sailing to his other house where he takes Zoom calls from his balcony while petting giraffes apparently. The only one you're cheating is yourself. Bullshit. Not out of laziness, but I was just not interested in secondary school. So there was this guy Kyle who would help me by letting me copy homework on the bus. Got my shit together in college. Win 2 scholarships, graduated master's with honors and summa cum laude, finishing off my PhD, which was just awarded around US$200,000 for further research. I'm waiting for Kyle to finish writing a postdoctoral application so I can continue on my path to professorship. Edit typos. I know I shouldn't have posted without Kyle's supervision. Automatics engineer, the stuff you learn on your own outside of school, and work experience is what counts. This is really something I wish more kids, especially in public schools, understood. The vast majority of what I've learned besides math and basic sciences came from personal research or practical experience. Especially in higher level courses, you're expected to read on your own and be proactive in your own education. The only thing I learned from school was how to write a banger essay and do well on standardized tests. two skills that have almost no practical application in my day-to-day life. Graduated college with a 3.8 GPA in computer science, starting my first job in my career field next month, and currently programming a game engine to teach kids, and other beginners, game design. Cheating was way more fun and required way more creative problem solving than actually studying, which was usually just straight memorization. Great training for real life edit. For the record, I don't cheat or lie in any context currently. High school was the last time I did this, as my college teachers were good and taught good enough to never require straight memorization. I only started this lifestyle once COVID hit. It sucks, I'm not learning nearly as much as I should be, and I barely feel like I'm a student. I'm not good at learning online. I'm fully vaccinated, and looking forward to in-person classes in the fall. And it makes you feel like a failure when you do it. I hate online school. I went to college for about 2 years. Didn't learn a single thing. Cheated my way through every class with at least a 3.0. I was in information technology for my college major. The next year I dropped out, had a couple awful odd jobs here and there. Then a friend asked me if I wanted a job working for her father. I now work it for a credit card processing company, making more money than all of my friends with 4-year degrees. I am a firm believer in, it's all in who you know. My friend in high school cheated absolutely every time he could. He wasn't dumb, just lazy. He didn't cheat to get highest score, but just to get above average. Today he realized multi-billion euros project to build hospitals. He was also from an old noble and decently wealthy family and had all the connections. All of them. Greater than he was also from an old noble and decently wealthy family and had all the connections. All of them. Literally the only part of this comment that matters. I'm a senior engineer at a really awesome tech company, smiley face. So cheat away, school doesn't mean much. Yeah, about that. You can't reliably cheat without having a general understanding of the subject, given that all exams are oral, and really really anal. This means that you are better than average at finding right information quickly. So in primary school we'd have tests every Tuesday to Friday on a set of words we had to learn to spell. We'd be given the words the day before, learn them overnight, come back and spell them the following day. So far, so good. So I get to my last couple of years in primary school and I run into a problem. Instead of us now being asked to learn to spell the word, we'd be told to go home and learn the meaning of the word, not just the spelling. We were no longer given the words to spell, but we were given the word's meaning, and had to decide which word it was, then spell it out. I'm not stupid, I'm not even close, but I could not do this for the life of me. I could spell the words fine. I knew the meanings of them. But I couldn't be told the meaning and then pluck the word from my memory, so for the last couple years I was in primary school I came close to failing every damn spelling test we had. I tried explaining this to my parents, but they insisted I just wasn't working hard enough and I was terrified of them finding out I was failing, because it didn't feel like it would end well at all. Thankfully every time our seating layout was changed, I ended up near someone who would understand my plight, and give me some sort of indication of what the word was. Not how to spell it, just give me the word. Never did it again after those couple of years and my schooling went just fine. A lot better than it would have done if I'd failed a spelling test because my brain couldn't brain properly. I've never been good at rote memorization. I have horrible memories of trying to learn all the states. Anyway, I had a teacher in like 6th grade that wanted us to learn all the prepositions. These are the words that describe where you are in relation to something else. E.g., on, under, atop, around. They're around 150 total, but I wasn't about to be able to memorize more than 20 of them. That said, I know what they are, so if you give me a list of words, I can circle the prepositions no problem. Long story short, my teacher let me write my own test that contained a list of words, prepositions and non-prepositions. I identified all the prepositions, did fine, and moved on with my life. She was a good teacher for letting me do something that matched my learning style well. I cheated on the bar exam. Few years later I got found out and lost my job. I'm at a community college now. I've become friends with 6 other people. We just started as a study group, but it's more now. I love the 2 people who responded to this seriously and totally missed the reference. I feel streets ahead of them. Cheating is meaningless. Graduated with a 3.95. have a steady job in a field that has nothing to do with my degree. I stored chemistry notes in my graphing calculator in high school tests. So the fuck what? It's meaningless. You know what working professional adults get to do? Read the fucking manuals whenever they need to. In fact, memorization is actively discouraged in my profession, because memorization likely means your information will be outdated within a couple months, if not weeks or days. If you do a job based on outdated information off the top of the dome, you're either wasting time or causing problems. Being adept with concepts, organization of resources, time management, and social skills is way, way more important than whether I Googled some bullshit about the ratification of the Magna Carta to ASA test 10 years ago. No one cares. Greater than no one cares. I care, a little. Asterisk, I do not want heart surgery from a surgeon who cheated to pass medical school. Asterisk, I do not want my bike brakes fixed by a mechanic who cheated to gain credentials. Asterisk, I do not want my taxes done by an accountant with a history of cheating. Asterisk, I do not want representation from a politician who cheated to get elected. There are plenty of jobs, like yours, where people require little formal training to succeed, but there are plenty of other jobs where training and adherence to rules matters. I used the Wolfram Alpha app on my calculus exam and got an A in the class. No regrets, especially because the class wasn't graded on a curve. Operations engineer. Cheating taught me how to avoid bureaucratic bullshit, get the results everyone cares about without having to ask how I did it, and budget time for the tasks I can't cheat. Glad I didn't miss the opportunity for real-life lessons in school. CEO of Citadel. Software. I still Google everything. Want some help? On Reddit, so perhaps the worst outcome. I couldn't cheat on my one AP exam I took, but I still made a 3 on it, so between that and a few other college classes I took in high school, it's the only college credit I have. 11 years later, without any student loan debt or college, I'm a mortgage underwriter making a base of $80,000 with OT, monthly bonus, and benefits. I can't cheat at this job, and I'm the a-hole who can't let other people get away with cheating either. I never cheated to be the best, but literally just to pass. I don't think I'm dumb, but I know I'm extremely lazy. I feel like I'm skating by with my mediocrity to just pass in life. Software engineer. Startup co-founder, serial entrepreneur. I learned that you often have to get creative and think outside the box to reach hard objectives, like getting a passing grade in accounting class or solving a hard engineering problem. I also learned that barely anything I have learned in school is relevant to real life. Therefore, cheating on those exams was worth it and without consequence. Those exams were just blockers in the way of graduating and moving on with my life. Cheat on your exams. Don't cheat in business. Don't cheat people, you'll be fine. I refused to cheat in school, though all my friends did. They are successful and I'm not. I struggle financially while they live in nice homes, drive new cars, and go on vacation to fancy resorts. Cheaters always prosper, that's just the truth. I mean, is it because they cheated or due to something else you lack? I own a web dev company and just turned 25. For me, school taught me nothing and I never saw the value in 99% of topics they taught, which made me unmotivated and the only way to pass was to cheat. I owe everything I have in life to Google, YouTube, and life experiences. CEO, and I only cheated on like 85% of them cause teachers got really good at finding my ways to cheat. Only 85%. Still the president. Stop the steal. I cut trees for a power company. I didn't cheat for the majority of my academic career, but vector and tensor analysis was so hard to stay awake through and I was having a rough year on a personal level. So maybe I didn't learn vector and tensor analysis as well as I paid to. Hasn't come up yet. I'm in a profession where a common motto is, if you're not cheating, you're not trying. Pretty good work position, lifelong contract. I don't think they exist in US. Many houses of my properties which I put M on rent for passive incomes. Got an attractive wife which my relationship with her is the only thing I've never cheated in and never will. I'm happy for you. Independently wealthy. I grew up poor and it sucked. I did any fucking thing I could to escape being poor. So yeah, I cheated like hell in school to get the right type of diploma, because higher education is another legal racket to fuck over the poor with. Just like politics, where the wealthy make sure the poor too busy fighting each other to notice they are getting fucked over by the people that own this country. Life is like carnival game, it's fucking rigged. So if you don't cheat, you are fucked.
Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.